Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Camilla and today we are building in Brindleton Bay, and actually we are kind of resuming something here because this is the second part of a two-part speed build. So if you missed the first part, I encourage you to go and watch it because here we are in the middle of decorating an art studio, and yeah, this probably wouldn't make much sense if you didn't watch the first part. So yeah, you can watch it, it's only 15 minutes, so yeah. I'll see you back here when you see it, like after you've seen it, I don't know. I'm kind of in the middle of an anxious breakdown, anxiety attack, I don't know how to call it, but so if I'm weird, that's why. I'm pretty weird most of the time, but today I'm exceptionally weird probably, so yeah, sorry about that. But yeah, my cat decided to give me some very not requested anxiety today and yesterday, so yeah, she's fine for now, I think. She's fine, she isn't dead. She tried to jump off my balcony, and she's not very agile, I'd say she's the least agile cat ever, so yeah, I'm pretty worried. I'm not usually so concerned, but yeah, she makes me feel this way because, like, I have reasons to feel this way. She's not very agile, she's very clumsy, and she falls everywhere, anywhere, every time, every single day, she falls from somewhere, from someplace, from a table, from a desk, from whatever. This is not the point of the video though, so yeah, as you can see, we are like going on with our speed build, with our mansion, and today we are kind of finish it up, wrapping up everything. We are working on the crops now, let's say. I had so much fun choosing different plants. We have some kind of fake crops in the debug menu, so that was fun, like to actually have something that looked like some crops, but then I used some normal plants, let's say, the ones that you can use for landscaping. I used them to act like crops, but as I was telling you in the previous part, you can of course remove them and actually have something like you can grow, you can physically grow in the game. Anyway, it would be very like time consuming, so consider hiring a gardener. I think it would be a nice idea. Anyway, last time I kind of said goodbye to you when I was talking about the family, so I think I'm gonna keep up, like continue talking to you about the family for a bit. And as I was telling you last part, I'm kind of getting rid of some chairs and stools to use the new stuff because we all love new shiny stuff, so yeah, I had to use the new items. But yeah, I haven't, like, I don't have the parents like super on focus, like I don't know exactly what they're into. I think they are of course into gardening, especially the father, while the mother is also like into art, and she loves to paint, like something that she sees on a daily basis. So you'll see a lot of nature themed portraits, pictures and paintings throughout the house. I use some gallery art, and I hope that I will remember to write the name of the creator, but I think it's of course Fruit Loops 40, yes. So if you want, you can check their art out because it's so cute, and I found some perfect art for this house. I found some leaves, some golden leaves on a blue background, and also like some flowers, and I thought the mom painted them, like, and she's kind of displaying her art throughout the house. As you saw here in the bedroom, I kind of worked around with the tool a bit to create a frame for that mirror because I liked that mirror. I wanted like a full length mirror, but I didn't have the perfect one, so I kind of created it myself. And this was supposed to be a sort of vanity, but then I found it too cluttered, too messy for a master bedroom, so I kind of took the clutter and placed it on the red shelf and put it downstairs. You'll see it in just a moment, because I thought it was more fitting for the daughter to have such a like a cluttered surface in her bedroom, so yeah. I don't think, like, I think I'm gonna show just a couple of bathrooms. You probably noticed it last time too, I didn't show much about the bathrooms because it's already a big mansion, I don't know, I don't want to get into that problem again this video, but yeah, it's a big house and so it's a long video and I had to cut something out. But I think the bathrooms are really cute and interesting. They're kind of different from each other but also cohesive except for the one the kids share on the second floor. This is probably my favorite bedroom, is the toddler's bedroom. It's all like, it's all themed around animals and nature, and I notice I tend to go for this theme when I'm decorating kids' bedrooms. And I'm totally wrong because I'm showing you another bathroom, and yeah, basically I don't know, I don't even remember what I cut out of the video, apparently. So yeah, let's go with the flow and don't worry about that. This is a kid's bedroom. I think this is the like bigger sister, the elder kid. She's into video games. She's not at all into nature or into gardening. I think she doesn't want to have anything to do with it once she's like she grows older and she goes to live on her own as a adult person, not living at home anymore. Yeah, so this room is very, very yellow, as you can see, and I played around with some posters and with some My Sims figures, but also like void critters, simis, the ones that you can find in the simi capsules since we got Snow Escape. And her brother is very into nature, but not into gardening necessarily. He's more into sports and like winter sports especially, and football. But he's kind of into everything because I gave him a bike, I gave him a snowboard, his bed is themed around like rock climbing, and I figured he wants to keep his bike in his bedroom because he doesn't trust anyone with his precious bike, and so he's more at peace with his bike in his bedroom. I don't know, and he's probably so like, he's looking forward to using the gym they have here in their house. Probably he's not allowed yet because he's too young, let's pretend. We know the fitness skill is not a thing for kids in The Sims 4, so we'll go for the storyline that says that he's not allowed to use the gym yet. So we are into the gym now and we are done with it, and in the basement in general, because we'll see that they have this gym and then this kind of spa situation with some massage tables. And they also have a half bathroom that I thought maybe the people who came here to give massages could use. And then there's the teen's bedroom, and she has her own ensuite, which is so cool. I'm so jealous of her. I don't know if I've already said that in the previous part, but I am, because she's so lucky. She has basically an entire floor to herself, and she has two entrances, one from outside and one from the house, so she can choose if she want to go upstairs with the family, or maybe if she has to sneak out at night, she can do that because she has a private entrance. And we also are gonna decorate now, as you can see, the butler's like studio apartment. I think it's so nice. I didn't decorate it too heavily because I figured that in a realistic situation, the butler would decorate it themselves, like according to their taste and their hobbies and whatever. So I kept the decorations to a minimum and the clutter to a minimum, except for a couple of plants. And I gave him also like his private like patio with a barbecue and a table. Maybe he could invite friends over, I don't know, how the butler thing works. If I know The Sims, though, it won't probably be like this. Like, it doesn't work like this. But yeah, if you want, you can play the storyline. And we are filling the barn with something else, like some activity stuff, some juice fizzers, and a fabricator, I think. No, it's not a fabricator. It's like the thing that recycles stuff. The thing that recycles stuff. Wow. As you can see, I added the flower arranging table. As I was telling you in the previous part, the teen is probably very into flower arranging. And I think her bedroom speaks like for her, because she has a ton of plants in her bedroom and she probably takes care of them personally. And so she's very into creating cute vases or vases, I don't know, to like for the flowers or for the plants. Maybe she's also into knitting, like since she has so many hanging plants with those crochet holders, or I don't know the name, but yeah, you get what I mean, I think. And as I was basically done with the whole house, I decided that I didn't like the landscaping, especially in the front, and that huge mass of plants in the backyard. So I changed everything. I also posted a picture on Twitter and someone commented that the landscaping didn't fit, and I was like, yeah, oh my god, if someone else like sees it, it's probably like this. So I got rid of everything and redid it, like keeping the plants that I used the first time, but in a tidier way, I think. Let me know if you preferred the old landscaping or if you like this one better. But this is like also the reason why in the last part I didn't show precisely like me doing the landscaping, because I knew that it would have been redone. So yeah, I didn't want to waste time. And yeah, I'm finishing it also here in the backyard. Then I realized I kept another flower bed, like another part of the landscaping here in the backyard, but that part is small and is more fitting than that mass of messy plants there behind the hot tub and the dining space. I don't know if you can get what I mean by this. So yeah, I think we are basically done with everything. We are just adding some last details, some plants, and the exterior lighting that took me ages, because I placed some lanterns manually on the columns of the different porches, and then I decided that I didn't like them, so I deleted them and I replaced them manually once again, and it took me ages. And also the very last touch, I think it will be the columns, because I don't know, I wasn't so sure, I wasn't so pleased with the house in general, and then I added the columns on the edges, on the corners, let's say, of the rooms of the house, and that gave me the final boost of confidence that I needed, and I was like, yeah, now I like it. And it was so funny because it was the very last thing that I did to this house. And I think I'm gonna also add it to my save file, like I put it into my save file. And if you download it, you will see that the roof clips into the living room, because when you delete the floor, the roof acts kind of weird. But in the finished version in my save file, I added that other roof trim, the one that doesn't show if you do this open concept, open landing area thing, or if you simply delete a floor on the second floor, that trim there doesn't show. And it's the last base game trim that we have in game. But anyway, I hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please make sure to leave a like, a comment, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I will see you all in my next video. I have a couple of them ready. My inspiration is back, I guess. So yeah, stay tuned for that. I will see you in the next video, and have a great day. Bye, everybody.